But what a lot of you don't know is that it almost took me 6 years, six long years, to actually save for it. I'll explain why. Now, a lot of you have asked me how I came up with the budget for my top surgery, if I've had any financial assistance or anything like that. But what a lot of you don't know is that it almost took me 6 years, six long years, to actually save for it. I'll explain why. I do not come from a rich family, nor am I saying that I'm poor. I guess it's safe to say that I am middle class. But yeah, I didn't have any form of financial assistance for my top surgery. I started saving for my top surgery ever since I started getting on T, which was 6 years ago. At the time, I didn't have any idea how much my top surgery would cost because I was still undecided on which surgeon I would want to go to. And because the only surgeons that we knew who performed these procedures were all based in Manila. That being said, I was not really fond of the idea of flying to Manila just to have my top surgery. So I took my time to save and I didn't mind waiting a bit longer. Of course, if I had a choice and if circumstances were better, I would obviously opt to have my top surgery as early as possible. If only I had the finances, the best option, the right support to do so, then I would definitely have had it earlier. So like I said, I didn't have a clear amount of how much I needed to save, but I was able to ask our fellow brothers who've already had theirs and got a range of how much the top surgeries would cost here in the Philippines. At about 2 years of saving, we were finally able to find a surgeon here in Cebu. So once we found out about that, I did go to have a consultation with that surgeon to have a clear amount of how much I needed to save. And after the consultation, honestly, the amount was too big to think about raising on my own. But I didn't stop there. Just because the price was overwhelming, I knew that that was one of the main goals in my life and that I really, really needed it. Anyway, back to how I saved up for it. So every time I had money, I did try to save as much as I could, no matter how big or small, even if it was just 100 pesos or thousands of pesos. If I was able to save it, I did it. The reason why it took me almost 6 years was that, of course, there will always be unexpected challenges wherein you have to spend your money, or there are emergencies where you have to take a portion of your savings. So every time that happened, I'd have to take a portion of my top surgery savings and spend for that. Then I'd have to save up for it again. So it was just a cycle of that throughout the years. Just when I was a few thousands away from the target amount, this pandemic happened. And that time, I did not know if it was wise for me to push through with the surgery or not. Because in the beginning of the pandemic, everything was so uncertain. I mean, even until now, it's still uncertain what would happen in the near future. But anyway, I was finally able to raise the amount last year, but we were all still stuck in quarantine. And I didn't feel like it was the right time to have it yet. And even though I was so eager to have it, I also prioritized safety. Fast forward to this year, where things cleared up a bit, and the rest is history. So guys, the reason why I'm making this video is to give a little bit of hope to those who really want to have their top surgery, but you think you cannot afford it. And as cliche as it sounds, it really is possible to work and save for it. I can't even count how many times I had to say no to my friends every time they asked me to go out with them, just because I was saving. I also had to discipline myself so many times. Every time I felt like going out or buying something or anything that required me to spend. And just remember, I started with zero savings. We all have to start somewhere. And it took me almost 6 years. And if you're one of the many individuals who are blessed enough to have the amount, then I'm happy for you. And I hope that you do what you think is best for you. So that's it for today's video. Thank you so much for always listening to what I have to say. Feel free to comment if there are topics that you want me to discuss. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe if you haven't already. See ya!